Millions of Filipinos are now covered by an insurance plan, but the government says that number is not enough. Jackie Pascual tells us the Insurance Commission is now pushing micro-insurance for low-income earners.
Anita Lagardos earns a living selling homemade snacks. She barely makes enough money for herself and her grandchildren. That's why getting an insurance plan is not an option for her. Anita is one of the millions of Filipinos not covered by any insurance policy.
Kulang nga sa budget. Siyempre, ang iyaan ko sa insurance, panggastos namin sa para pagkain.
In a country that faces natural and man-made calamities each year, threats to life and property are ever present.
A fishbowl vendor, no, nagbebenta siya ng mga lako-lako niya, then disaster struck, nasira yung kariton niya, wala siyang source ng kita.
The Insurance Commission is urging Filipinos to try micro-insurance, which caters to low-income earners. 26.6 million Filipinos are covered by micro-insurance, but the commission hopes more people will avail of the policy.
We are 110 million people. They should be given the right to protect themselves, not only financially, but also the right to protect their property and lives.
Having an insurance plan will also benefit the country, for when a calamity strikes, an insured person would get some monetary benefit without government overstretching its budget.
We only have about 20-28% of the Filipinos covered by microinsurance. This means to say that we still have quite a number of Filipinos that need to be covered.
Insurance was really a scary word, and we had to educate people that insurance was good. Now the Filipinos really are embrace microinsurance.
Cebuana Luwilier says its microinsurance policy only requires contributions of 40 pesos every 4 months or 120 pesos for 1 year. Policyholders can get 20,000 pesos in case of death or disablement. Not bad, Anita says. She's now hoping to earn additional money so she can avail of the insurance policy. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.